Rock, report range status.
Range green.
T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go for main engine start. 0 and liftoff.
ODARC 30, Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. With a full week of intense rocket assembly activities ahead, the teams from Launch Services Program and United Launch Alliance are getting an early start. It all begins with the booster. The booster is the backbone of the Atlas V, and literally everything is riding on it. It's the largest component and first to be lifted.
The Launch Services Program partnered with United Launch Alliance to select the Atlas 541 vehicle because it is one awesome rocket, and we need that thrust to get GOES-S to its geostationary orbit to meet its mission requirement.
It will take more than just the booster to get all the way to geostationary orbit. That's why we're adding four solid rocket boosters.
When you start with the Atlas booster, it's like 860,000 pounds of thrust with just the RD-180. So we need the solids for extra performance. We need it to get heavy payloads off the pad and for additional performance going to geosynchronous orbit or geotransfer. Mating the solids to the booster is a very hazardous operation. We have safety with us at all times. You have 100,000 pounds going up into the air and hanging on a crane. And oh, by the way, it's explosive.
Once the solids are mounted, it's time to mate the Centaur.
The Centaur is the upper stage, and it's tuned. It's like a highly tuned race car. It's light, it's efficient, it performs well for us.
We're all here to do the job and get it done right. If you see something that's not right, bring it up to us. Let's give us a chance to fix it, okay? All right, let's get in position to do this thing.
Assembling a rocket can make or break any mission. It takes tremendous coordination and skill to get this job done. The team makes it look easy, but rocket science never is.
The coolest part of my job is coming down here and seeing the hardware and knowing what it's capable of. We all get to work with rockets, and it's really exciting and fun, and everybody has their part in all of that. And yeah, when you're out with friends, you can say you're a rocket scientist. I do.
So there's really nothing quite like all the work and all the setup that we do to get ready to do this and get built up the rocket and tested to get to launch day. And when we get to T0 and the rocket lifts off and the control room rattles and shakes a little bit, it's an awesome feeling. That is the ultimate reward, and that's really what makes us happy. What makes our customer happy is putting our customer where they want to go in the right spot in the exact right orbit, and that is a lot of pride in that.
This rocket is almost ready to roll. Of course, the only thing missing is its GOES-S payload.